come up.
Hey, J.O., you made the beat.
Gotta make the right decision, no, it might just be my last. People view everything different when you touching on the back. What you see is good intentions, it's for clout and haters mad. You can never be a subject, you carry, gotta wear a mask. They be pulling at you, grabbing at you, pop up trying to change you. I built my own foundation and there ain't no rearranging. Moving careful every day, exactly how I played it. Not looking for number one, but that's exactly how I'm pacing. I got choices, I'm getting opinions from so many folks to bring the horses. So I can get up away from all the noise. Too many people tell me what I should do, I take it and laugh. They not knowing if I mess up, I can end up falling flat. If I write a bad tweet, lagging in my whole street. If I give them what they want, then I'm gonna be broke in a week. If I tell my baby no, she might get it from the street. If I'm not tough on my son, he might grow up to be weak. What do I do? I'm new to having cameras in my face. What do I do to keep getting the love from my state? What do I do to keep the money coming in? What do I do? Writing it till I need another pen. Gotta make the right decision, no, it might just be my last. People view everything different when you touching on the back. What you see is good intentions, it's for clout and haters mad. You can never be a subject, carry, gotta wear a mask. They be pulling at you, grabbing at you, pop up trying to change you. I built my own foundation and there ain't no rearranging. Moving careful every day, exactly how I played it. Not looking for number one, but that's exactly how I'm placed. Feel like Jesse Owens, cause I'm taking off with the race. Put the metal to his mouth, retain his tongue, hold the brace. But I'm all about the peace until the sucker hit a make. Oh man, eat man, your performance kinda shaky. I'm prepared for fame, I like that cash, I'm really like me. But I'd be lying if I said I didn't finally sponsor you.
First opened in 2002, there's a look inside Ford Field here in downtown Detroit, the Motor City. Both teams emerging from the Ford Field tunnels just a short time ago. And, of course, the loudest cheers were reserved for the hometown Lions. They're set to go as they will match up with the Philadelphia Eagles. The NFL season has hit high gear, and off we go in Week 11 on EA Sports. And they will elect to not bring this one out as our first drive will begin at the 25. Sanders, and not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26. He'll look to throw. And they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete.
That's a nice job there because you've got to play the ball, not the man when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties. And he's able to knock that one away.
So trouble already here on their opening drive. This is 3rd and 9. He'll look to throw. That's caught by the big tight end, Dallas Goedert. And he is going to have an Eagles first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
We often hear the phrase sure-handed tight ends, and he certainly fits into that category. Plus, he's got a quarterback who knows to look his way when they need a big pickup. And on this play, he finds him for the first down.
On first down, Hurts. Smith catches left side. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out.
But I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere, and they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well, and that's what they just did on that play.
So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. Now they'll run the option to the short side left. Give him 4 yards there on the first down keeper.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. He wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. And the throw led him too much that time. It's incomplete.
They'll put a check mark in the box where the defense coordinator was saying, how well can we stay with these receivers if we're in man coverage? Because he just did it on that one. Forced the incompletion. That allowed him to get bolder with his pass rush, won't it?
Absolutely. Frees up your guys elsewhere. The first down line at the 34 here on third down. They'll set up a throw. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on third down.
And that is no good. And this will remain a scoreless game. Well, that opening drive looked good for a moment there, but they'll wind up being turned away thanks to the missed field goal.
And those especially hurt when you come into a game on the road. You're trying to get things to go your way early, and now you suffer a setback right out of the gate.
Well, now they'll start 3 yards shy of midfield after that long 57-yard miss. First carry for DeAndre Swift. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Well, this defense for the Eagles, they played extremely well last week in the win over Atlanta.
Yeah, and what stood out to me on tape, the way they were flying to the football. So that tells me that they've got all their assignments down, and they're playing with extreme confidence.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10.
Let's set a tone, fellas. Let's set a tone. Listen.
Now Goff. The connecting here with DJ Shark. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Goff a handoff here to Swift. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means you're off. Defense has to keep pace.
Just beating the play clock is gone. He's going to get that to Swift underneath. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and that's going to lead to a third down.
And that last throw right there putting him already over 3,000 passing yards now for the campaign.
And given where we are in the season, Brandon, you have to think to yourself, if he stays healthy, I think 4,000 is a given. I think 5,000 is not out of the question if he stays hot.
Third and 2, gone. Here's a diving catch right side. And he is going to have a Lions first down. It's a gain of 6 that time on 3rd and 2.
When you're a player of his stature, you don't just circle the games on your team's calendar. You
circle the Pro Bowl?
Without a doubt. That's a game that you just figure you're going to be in each and every year. And it's because of catches like that. That's why he goes.
On 1st and 10, it's Swift. And here he'll get it down to the 7. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a 2nd and just about a few inches here.
Now that was an excellent run. And when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block. But the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've got to hit the jackpot there.
So not quite a 1st and goal just yet as they come up now 2nd and inches. From the gun, here's Swift. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4.
It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy, let him pick up the first down.
1st and goal from just inside the 5. No score after 1 on EA Sports. Here we go now on 1st and goal. And now the first throw for the backup quarterback. Buying time to his left. And he takes this one in for a Lions touchdown. A great play there. His 2nd touchdown on the season. As his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. Now the extra point try forthcoming. It's up, it's good, and the Lions lead 7-0.
Lions 7, Eagles nothing.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive.
They are back over the 500 mark for the season. Got there with a win a week ago, their 2nd straight victory.
Well, they've definitely gotten better as this season has gone along, and from what I can tell, they know their roles. Everyone understands how they fit offensively, defensively. And this team now has an identity, and they're playing to it and playing well.
Brings up second and three.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and three. They'll fake the give to Sanders, and now Hurts. Rolling, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. He couldn't get away. He'll wind up losing a dozen yards, a 12-yard loss, and it brings up third. And the Lions going with an extra DB here on third down. Throwing is Hurts. Going deep here for Watkins. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
That looks like it's going to be two empty possessions now to start this football game. I think they're going to have to sit down and talk about what worked for them last week in their win. Sometimes you over-game plan, overthink things, get back to what works.
Here's Williams to return. 54-yard punt, 14 on the return, nets him 40. And the Lions will take over. Offense ready to kick off their next drive. Now they'll be looking to duplicate the efforts of drive number one that resulted in 7 points in the 7-zip lead.
Well, you know how much I enjoy horse racing, right? Looks like they caught a flyer out of the gate, as they would say when you're running the big time races. It means they got out to a fast start. They're setting the pace, making the other team chase now.
I think the reason this play is so successful is not just the blocking at the point of attack, but how about the speed at which he takes the handoff? He's in motion already. So he's not coming from a flat start like a running back often is. He's at a full run by the time he gets the football.
First and 10, and they've got three tight ends out there. A jumbo package look. On the handoff, this is Swift. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
Second and nine, Goff. And Sharp hauls it in. And he has another first down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles 30.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
So first and 10 now from the 30. They run out of the gun with Swift. And he'll be brought down at about the 25 after a pickup of four.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
Now a second down and six. Here's a handoff to Swift. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down.
Brings up third and seven.
They'll look to throw. This is intercepted. Picked off at the 24. And the return stops at the 39-yard line.
That pick hurts a little extra because it was third down. You were already in field goal range.
You know what he's going to hear all night, all next week? Situational football. Understand what's going on, because you expressed it perfectly. 3 points were in their hip pocket. They had those. Now, those went by the wayside. You cannot make those kind of mistakes.
That's what you call a rookie mistake.
They start on the ground here at Sanders. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. 6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. Hurts. And that'll be incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
The Eagles on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third and four. Back to throw. They'll get this one complete. That's A.J. Brown. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. 2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth,
yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy.
On first and 10, it's Hurts. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
Martin, I think it's high time to get him some passes that he's comfortable with. Some easy throws, some completions. He's not even hitting the 50% thus far.
Well, certainly that has played a big role into why they are trailing right now. Hurts gets this to Sanders, and he'll go down at the 26, following a gain of 6.
It's a gain of 6, and it's third down.
Hurts sets up to throw it. That is caught. It's the tight end, Goddard. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10, and mark him at the 5.
And in a lot of ways, that catch is expected. Red zone presence, and that one was realized there. You've got to find your tight end in that situation.
Hurts going to give it to Sanders on the option. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the 1. When we talk about being on schedule, I think they're on schedule after that run, getting it right down there on the doorstep.
Maybe even a little bit ahead, because now the defense can't dictate with pressure. They're guessing about where you're going to go. I might come right back at them with the same play, the same set, and see if they can stop them.
And this will result in him losing yardage. Back to the 3. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. From back at the 3 now, this is third and goal. Here's Hurts to throw. And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Miles Sanders hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Eagles are on the board here in the final minute of the first half. Elliott Good with a PAT, and we are tied here in the second quarter.
Jake Elliott to kick off for Philadelphia.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. A fairly short kick from the 14, and he'll be out of bounds across the 25. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive.
And we'll see how they want to play this. Just a little over 20 seconds to go.
Goff on first down. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Out of the gun, gone. Open man right side is Shark. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. Now Goff on first down. That's caught by the big tight end, T.J. Hockenson. And offensively, they'll take the timeout with 6 seconds left in the second quarter.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
And this one is right down the middle. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. So a big play before the end of the half to get him into this spot, and they cash in with three.
How about the 1-2 to the solar plexus on that one? The big play, the field goal, not much time left on the clock. That's the way to go into the half.
Short, short kick. One of the up men will take it down. And they're going to have good starting field position. He's out of bounds, but not before he's across the 35. So we've reached halftime here in Detroit with the Lions out on top. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three.
The Lions in the lead, and they're going to get the football first as well as the second half is underway. Taken at the 15, a short kick, and makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Offense ready to kick off their next drive. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. A little jet sweep to start the drive. And he is met at the line of scrimmage and he goes down right there. No gain on the play there. Second down.
Let's just make this one succinct. Nice job there. All 11 guys on defense diagnosing the jet sweep and putting it down.
From the gun, here's Goff. It's caught on the right side, Williams. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard.
20.
Goff now looking to throw.
That's complete to Swift out of the backfield. And he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to convert by plenty there on third and one.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Goff. They'll try and set up the screen to Swift. Powers through it. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. Just a terrific run there, Charles, from a running back who is so compact and powerful, and that strength was on display there.
Yeah, that's a run born out of ferociousness. He took on that initial contact and in his mind just screamed, out of my way, and kept right on going and wound up turning it into a big play.
And you can see the distance traveled there after the initial contact on the Next Gen Stats. So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 right at the 40. Here's Swift. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
Well, Charles, you know, you think about this defense. This week in preparation, you couldn't hide the fact from them that they're facing a team that's lost 7 in a row. You just wonder if they prepared the same way they normally do.
Yeah, that's a great question, because normally that preparation goes into what you do well on defense. Woodell, I would expect them to throw every trick play in the book right out of the gate in order to try and get something established and get things moving.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
But listen, when you've got the lead, there's absolutely no sense trying to fit a ball in where you shouldn't. You can see the coaching in his head taking place on that play, because he saw he had a receiver in the area, and he just put it well over his head, out of harm's way.
After the incompletion, here now, third and 2.
BC.
Now Goff. This is caught by Williams. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. This home crowd, they're happy with that call.
I like the way you said happy there, right? The so-called good guys didn't get a call. They feel like it's been that way all afternoon. You feeling their pain?
They finally got one.
Yes, they did.
They'll run on first down. Swift, and a good run as he manages 7 yards down to the 17.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive, because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense gets a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. Goff now looks to throw. Got a man over the middle. It's Williams. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11.
Had to put that ball in there with a little extra zip, but he put it right where it needed to be.
Yeah, that little extra pace that he had on the pass, that required a little extra concentration for him, didn't it? Ball can get on you pretty quick in that manner, and he handled it well and picked up the first down.
Now a 1st and 10 at the 11.
Hey, come kill!
Now it's Swift. And he'll take this one inside the 10, down to the 8. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Three yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7.
Let's go. Alert 3, alert 3, alert 3.
They go jet sweep here with Williams. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. They'll get a couple yards on that one, and that'll bring up a third down.
Defensively, they had that one pretty well figured out.
Yeah, and one of the things about this play, it can be even more effective when you run a lot of motion and there's plenty of times you don't hand it off.
Out of the gun now on third down. Sliding out of the pocket. And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the 1.
Now that's disappointing for the defense. They had the advantage, had excellent coverage all over the field, but they let him get away, scramble, and pick up a first down and inside the 5-yard line.
Looks like a jumbo set with 3 tight ends here for first and goal. They'll run with Swift into a mass of bodies, and I think they held him out. They did. No gain on the play, and it's going to be second and goal.
They're right there at the 1. No gain, but don't let that stop you. Line back up and keep going at them. If I'm them, I'm thinking about going at it 4 straight times.
Another shot from the 1 on second and goal. One more time with Swift. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. DeAndre Swift, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the Lions take the opening kickoff of the 3rd quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Extra point splits the uprights, and his guys will take a 10-point lead.
17, Eagles 7.
Is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll be out of bounds here just past the 20-yard line.
At their own 21-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive.
And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go 3 and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
Is going to do it for this 3rd quarter of action. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
On first down, it's Sanders. And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
Brings up second and seven at the 43-yard line.
Another run here with Sanders. He can't get him down. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. The Eagles on third down. They've converted four times out of six. Not bad. They need just a yard here. It's third and one. Play action. Here's Hurts. Oh, he's going to go for it all. And I think that one might have been intercepted, but he will be ruled out of bounds. So this will go only as incomplete.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Going for it with Sanders. And I'm not sure he got there. Did they stop him? They did. He needed a yard. He didn't get anything. And the Lions will get the football back in terrific field position. They'll run on first down. Swift. And he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much as he's down to the 48. Davion Taylor there to bring him down. To Swift again on second down. It's a gain of about three, but it's going to leave him with third and still 7 yards to go. I think you'd have to say defensively, these guys are doing their job pretty well, right?
Yeah, we talked about them holding them under 20 points, right, on defense, and they've done that. They've held them. The problem is their own offense hasn't answered their challenge, which was to score more.
Yeah, exactly. I remember you saying magic number was right around 20, and the offense has been the issue. You're right. The Lions on third down. They've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. This is third and seven.
Come on, baby. Let's see what you got.
Back to throw here. And this is going to be incomplete.
Well, this at least is the right idea. I think they've got to get the tight end more involved.
He had just one target in the first half, incomplete. Now incomplete here with the first target of the second half.
Yeah, should not stop them at all from going back to him. They'll find him. Find him.
And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. They go ahead and snap it. Gone. And he's going to have his running back. It's complete. And he's got this down to the 35. They're looking to put this game on ice in the fourth quarter, but still not afraid to throw it, as they show there.
You want to play the game with confidence, and they have a guy who's in control right now. Their trigger guy throwing it, they feel just as confident with him doing that as they would if they tried to run the ball and run the clock out.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10.
Let's go, defense. Here we go.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And past the 30, down to about the 27. 49 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame. Starting to become a tough spot for this defense. You're down fourth quarter, looking a little fatigued maybe on that side of the ball.
Partner, we've seen this before, haven't we? Because every coach we've ever talked to says body language is important. And now you're seeing guys with their hands on their hips, they're bent over, hands on their knees. And the offensive guys are just saying, let's just keep running it at them. We've got them now.
Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. He'll lose a yard on the play, so now they need 3 yards on third down. Now back to throw. He'll buy some time right. Brian has it. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the five.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. Here's Swift. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Now a timeout coming in here defensively as they stop it before the 2-minute warning with 2:09 to go in the game. Now from the 7, here's second and goal. Once again, it's Swift. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up.
We all know how much running backs love getting the ball down near the goal line. They think they're going to find a way into the end zone. He hasn't had that kind of luck so far. Ends up not getting in on the last 2 carries. You know he's going to be upset about a missed opportunity.
And now can they reverse the trend on third and goal with the last 2 plays having gone backwards? A shotgun snap for Goff.
And that's out to the flat for Swift.
And in for the Lions touchdown. DeAndre Swift with his 2nd touchdown of the game, number 7 on the year. And the Lions add on to their lead, and they appear poised to break this long losing streak. Extra point right down the middle. And that'll make this a 3-score game now. The lead moves to 17. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. But first down, Hurts. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
So following the incompletion here, second and 10 from the 25. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. Complete, Smith has it. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8. They run with Sanders off the option as Sanders has it poked free. And this is scooped up by the Lions. And they will set up shop in enemy territory at the 42-yard line.
And with that kind of a deficit, you can't afford to make any kind of mistakes. But it's been pretty symptomatic of what we've seen all game with them, isn't it? Down this big in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you'd say an afternoon to forget, absolutely. Throwing now, Goff. He's going to air one out. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
I'm looking at this one with my defensive eyeglasses on because you remember the old days when a tight end saw a linebacker covering him and thought he had a mismatch? But the way they can run nowadays, not necessarily so. They gave it a shot downfield. That one incomplete.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Here's Goff. Throw right side, complete to Williams. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. Second and 6. Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6. Off play action, here's Goff. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because it nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a 3rd and 6. Now it's gone. Oh, what a heck of an effort there as he'll make the diving catch. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages.
First and 10 at the 18-yard line.
Goff. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked by the former Lion, Darius Slay. And the Eagles will take over here at their own 14-yard line.
Yeah, he's just trying to throw this ball into the hole in the zone, but those windows can open and close quickly, especially in the middle of the field. So if the timing's not right, we'll see interceptions like that one right there.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Now, this game went off the rails early for them and never really got back on track. And these fans, they were expecting to be on the other side of the scoreboard, but that is not the case as we play on here in this fourth quarter. That catch good for only a couple.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
From the 16, Hurts. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Smith. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Play action with Hurts. And he's got his man. It's the tight end Goddard. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you
throw it across his body, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 35, and the Lions come up with a late turnover, but it will probably only matter to the statisticians as this ball game is now officially over. So this one's up.